Hello, family. Today's topic is serving versus swerving. This is one of my favorite topics, but before I go ahead and share my opinion, let's see what the word has to say. Join me in Ephesians 2:10. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. See, God created each and every one of us with a unique purpose. He equipped us with certain personalities, certain skills, so that we may be able to make an impact on the church here on earth. See, and when you get plugged in, you're able to use those skills that God has created and equipped you with. Also, when you serve, you're surrounded by amazing human beings. And these leaders, they love on you and they strive to encourage you on a weekly basis. They mentor you. They celebrate you when you are celebrating life's accomplishments. We even cry with you when you are in those trials and in those seasons of life. We lift you up. We bring you back to the Word because you are not alone. We also strive to get you out of your comfort zone. And we're there by your side to see you bloom to your full potential. And on this journey, you also find your purpose. I know I did. And I want to share some benefits of serving. There's hundreds of them, but I just want to share four. The first one is you gain an extended family. Number two is fellowship. Number three is you grow spiritually and also mentally. And number four is it's humbling. You need to remember, you don't have to serve, but you get to serve in God's house. And man, that is an honor. So now let's talk about swerving, right? Swerving is scary. There's windy roads, it's bumpy, there's storms, and some parts you're gonna hit some dark spots. And you weren't created to do life alone. You were created for fellowship. And in Matthew 9:37, it says, "Then he said to his disciples, 'The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few.'" Listen, there's a lot of work to be done in the kingdom, but few are willing to do the work. I encourage you, don't be the few. And I want to take a quick exercise with you. Very quick. Close your eyes. Hurry up. Close your eyes. I want you to go back of before you said yes to Christ. How was your life before? Where were you mentally? Think about it. I know for me, I was broken. I was lost. I was unemployed. My marriage was not in a good place. It was a very, very dark time in my life. Now fast forward. When you said yes to Jesus, remember that. Remember that moment. Remember the joy. Remember the excitement. Remember the overwhelming love that you felt. Remember the fire that you can do anything because you weren't alone. Now stay in that moment right there. See, he saved you and me. Jesus gave his life for you and me. It wasn't the nails that held him down. It was the love. Because he loved us so, so much. And I know for me, I could never repay him for that selfless act that Jesus did for me. But I know for me, every time I serve, it's like me personally giving Jesus a hug and thanking him for what he did. Because I get to serve his children here in church. And I get to serve my pastors that he has anointed and called for such a time as this. Serving isn't about me or you. It's about the one who saved, and that's Jesus Christ. So I pray that this spoke to you. I pray that you're excited and that you can't wait to serve. And even more exciting is we're going to have an interest meeting January 16th at 9 a.m. here. You can go ahead and go to our app, sign up, come to the meeting. You can talk to us. Any type of questions that you may have, we can answer them. And also, or if you're like, you know what, I want to get in, I want to dive in, I want to serve right now, you can also go to our app, go ahead and click on connect, and then you're going to go ahead and click on volunteer. There is a form that you fill it out, hit submit, and there you go. Easy peasy. So I am looking forward in serving alongside of each and every one of you. And I hope to see you there at the interest meeting. Have an amazing day. See ya.